Gross domestic product, GDP for short, can be thought of as an overall grade on the economic report card of a country or region. It's one way to measure the size and growth of the economy. For example, if the year-to-year GDP is up 3%, this means that the economy has grown by 3% over the last year. In order to determine the GDP, economists at Statistics Canada compile a massive amount of data, including information from hundreds of surveys that are completed by Canadian businesses, the government, and Canadian households. Several methods are used to determine the GDP. One of the most direct methods is called the value-added approach. To explain it, let's start with our standard definition of GDP, which is the value of output, less intermediate consumption, plus any taxes, less subsidies on products not already included in the value of output. You might find that definition a little hard to follow, so let's break it down with an example. For this example, let's also assume that the taxes less subsidies on products not already included in the value of output is equal to zero. All right, let's say you have an automobile assembly plant. Every year, the plant produces all sorts of cars. The total worth of all the cars produced annually in the factory is $1 million. That $1 million in the production of cars is considered to be the output. Let's return to the definition. GDP is the value of output, in this case the value of the cars, less intermediate consumption. So, what is intermediate consumption? Well, let's say the automobile assembly plant needs to purchase $700,000 worth of car parts from the motor vehicle parts manufacturing industry before it can fabricate the $1 million worth of cars. The $700,000 worth of car parts is considered to be intermediate consumption. To return to the definition again, GDP in this case is the output of $1 million worth of cars less the intermediate consumption, which is $700,000 for the car parts. So in our example, $300,000 is considered to be the GDP of the car assembly plant. But the story doesn't end there. Let's look at the motor vehicle parts manufacturer that produced the parts for the assembly plant. In order to produce the parts, it first had to purchase steel from the steel mill. Before that, the steel mill had to purchase the iron ore from a mine, and so on. Each of these industries involved in the process, harvesting the ore, making the steel, making the car parts, etc., has its own output and intermediate consumption, which also means that each industry has its own GDP. The GDP values of each of these industries must all be added together to reflect the total GDP of the economy. So although the GDP of the automobile assembly plant is only $300,000, the GDP attributed to the entire economy would be much higher. In fact, it could actually be closer to, well, $1 million. To summarize, in the example that was just illustrated, we identified four industries that were included in our little economy. Those industries were the automobile assembly industry, the motor vehicle parts manufacturing industry, the steel manufacturing industry, and the iron ore mining industry. The sum of the value added of each industry gave us the total GDP for the economy. Gross domestic product is the meter stick of the economy. Broadly, when it's increasing, the economy is said to be growing. If GDP is slowing down or negative, it can be an early sign of recession. That's why we take care to provide Canadians with access to accurate, up-to-date GDP data. You can learn more about GDP at www.statcan.gc.ca.